Dr. Lowe, I'm Dean Farmer, and this is Communications 101. Welcome to the SCBA training class. Monroe County is on the cutting edge of quality training. We're training the use of this equipment. You can prevent harm or loss of life during fire operations. And now I would like to introduce the equipment. This is the self-contained breathing apparatus, or we refer to it as the SCBA. This part is the harness, a backpack actually. It holds everything together. This is the mask. It's actually worn over your face.
And tighten the top straps.
This is the cylinder. It has 2,216 pounds of pressure in it. It's good enough for about 30 minutes of air. This here is a device that allows us to refill it or replenish the air if you're in if you need more air. This is the pass device. It's probably one of the more important things. What it does is while you're wearing it and if you stop moving or have any kind of trouble, it alerts safety personnel outside. If you are in an emergency situation and you need help, it's got a panic alarm. Now I'm going to demonstrate the usage of this device. I'll actually put it on and breathe air. The use of the turnout gear, which is the jacket and the pants I have, the mask, the helmet, can protect you in temperatures up to 1600 degrees for only a few minutes. Luckily, most of the time it's not that hot in the house, but it can get pretty warm. So when you're using this, you would have every part of your skin covered. Camera, I'm getting nervous.
Okay, then before you would enter the building, you would connect your mask or connect your regulator, having everything covered. But it makes it hard to talk through the mask. That concludes the demonstration
concludes this part of the class, and I would like to thank everybody for coming. I'd like to especially thank Corey for handling the video projector. And I thank Malcolm and AJ for coming in and listening to this on the day off. Thank you, guys. And that's it. Thank you.